Hello students, how are you? Are you doing well? Did you go through the lesson? Today is Friday. Did you go through the Thursday's lesson? Were you able to understand? What about the glossary? Did you do the homework? Did you write the glossary? That is the meaning of the keywords. If students, you didn't write, try to write and submit. Okay. Now, I think you know something about Don Quixote. And now we can go through the next part. Turn to page number 90. Here, first he goes and attacks. Just I would like to remind you the previous day's portion. Don Quixote attacks the auger first, that is the windmill, and he is wounded. And next he goes and attacks the sheep. Here also the shepherds throw stones against him and he fell wounded on the ground. Then Sancho Panza goes and helps him. He also says and warns not to do, and he pleads him and he requests him, "No master, don't go. It is not an army, it is a herd of sheep," he says. Even though he doesn't hear the Sancho's words, and he goes and attacks and he gets wounded. Now we'll start today's lesson. Page number 90, turn to page number 90. Today's lesson, see here. Adventures of Don Quixote, page number 82. Now we have completed till page number 89. Then you have to turn to page number 90. Here, what does Sancho say? "Sancho, look, see how the people welcome us. They must have heard of our great deeds." See, Don Quixote says to Sancho that the people are welcoming Don Quixote and they have heard of the great victory of Don Quixote. So they are welcoming, he says to Sancho. But Sancho, what is the reply of Sancho? See here. "Oh no, master, listen very carefully. They are not welcoming us. They are mocking you. They are not welcoming us, but they are laughing at you," he says. Don Quixote did not understand and thought the people were cheering for him. Now also, he doesn't hear Sancho's words. He says that they are laughing and they are mocking, he says at Don Quixote. But Don Quixote thinks that people are encouraging him because of his victory, because of his deeds, great deeds, he thinks. And now, very well, we shall speak no more of this today. But we need more adventures, Sancho. Now we will stop speaking about this deeds and about this great victory. And we have to go for adventure and do more adventure, he says. Don Quixote says, "Yes, master, we need more adventures." He also accepts master's words and he also says that they need more adventures. Return to his estate. Now Don Quixote comes to his estate. Return to his estate, Don Quixote realized that all his adventures were simply a product of his imagination. Don Quixote never embarrassed himself further by going on any more quests. Now, here cheering means encouraging. Mocking means, first one you have mocking here. Mocking means laughing. Here cheering means encouraging. Next one, realized. Realized means here you have realized. Realized means recognized. Realized means recognized. Now he comes to his place and he recognizes, realizes. It is only imagination. He recognizes and he hereafter he doesn't search anything anymore. And here embarrassed means felt ashamed. He is ashamed of his deeds and he doesn't go any more quest. He doesn't go for any more search and he doesn't go for any more adventures. Then but his house would always be full of children to whom we would tell the most fantastic stories about knights, squires and noble quests, and all lived happily together, going on many more adventures in their imagination. Here his house is full of children. He says the stories about knights, squires and noble quests. Noble quest means great men. Noble means great men. He tells the stories about them and all they live happily together, going on more adventures. Just in imagination, not in real. It is not real. His adventures are not real. Don Quixote's adventures are not real. Just in imagination, he does all these adventures. So, students, now you are able to understand the story, I think. You go through, you read the dialogues and try to understand. If you are not able to understand, try to ask your doubts. I'll answer you. Okay, now I'll go to book back exercise. First question, answer the following questions. What kind of books did Don Quixote like to read? What were those books like? Just write the answer. You have to write it down. I'll show you and I'll read you. Don Quixote liked to read about knights and squires. These books were about courageous knights and their incredible adventures. Now write it down. I'll dictate the answer for the first question. What kinds of books did Don Quixote like to read? What were those books like? This is the first question. Again, I'll read it, write it without spelling mistake. Don Quixote, use capital letter. Don Quixote liked to read about knights and squires. Knight spelling K-N-I-G-H-T-S. And squire spelling S-Q-U-I-R-E-S. Squires. This is the first sentence. Second sentence, start with capital letter. These books were, T-H-E-S-E. These books, B-O-O-K-S, books were about courageous, C-O-U-R-A-G-E-O-U-S. Courageous knights, K-N-I-G-H-T-S. And they are incredible adventures. And they are incredible adventures. Incredible spelling, I-N-C-R-E-D-I-B-L-E. Incredible adventures. AD ad VEN TURES. Incredible adventures. Next one, second question. What effect do the things Don Quixote reads have on him? Second one, you have to write it down. Second one answer, he hardly, H-A-R-D-L-Y. First one, H-E-H-A-R-D-L-Y, hardly remembered, R-E-M-E-M-B-E-R-E-D, remembered, to eat or sleep, T-O-2, next word, E-A-T-E, O-R, next word, S-L-E-E-P, sleep. He imagined himself as a knight. He imagined, I-M-A-G-I-N-E-D, imagined himself, H-I-M-S-E-L-F, himself as a knight, K-N-I-G-H-T, knight. Okay, students, now I have given two questions. Just you read the two questions and write it as homework and submit it. Rest we can see on Monday. Thank you, children. Thank you.